Our first guest, Jason Zweig, is the author of Your Money and Your Brain, How the New Science of Neuroeconomics Can Help Make You Rich. Zweig, a senior writer for Money Magazine, reports on the latest research in neuroscience, why our investing brains often drive us to do things that make no logical sense and how to overcome it. In a recent interview, I asked Jason Zweig how he got the idea for a book about the powerful connection between money and the brain.
Well, I realized almost 10 years ago, Consuelo, that the markets don't always behave the way people would like them to. And of course, this is no great discovery.
Oh, really? Yeah.
It's no great discovery. But I started to wonder why people don't learn from their own mistakes. You know, we're all intelligent people. Anyone watching this show is a very intelligent person. Professional investors are highly intelligent people. But we keep making the same mistakes, and we make them over and over and over again.
And some of the same mistakes are?
Well, for example, buy high, sell low. trade more than you should. Mm-hmm. Ignore expenses when you know they're important. Be more confident about the quality of your information than is actually justified by the evidence. People do this all the time. And we do it, and then we go back and we do it again. For example, the people who bought technology stocks in the spring of 2000 for infinite multiples of their worth, only a few months ago were buying energy stocks mm-hmm. for huge multiples of their worth. And there are still commentators in the market who say you can't pay too much for a great company. Well, of course you can, and they should know that too. And why do we not learn from our mistakes? And it started to occur to me that there might be a science that would explain this, and it turns out there is. It's called neuroeconomics.
So what is neuroeconomics?
Well, as you'd guess from the name,
right.
It's a combination of neuroscience, economics, and psychology. And it's an interdisciplinary field that uses modern imaging technology and other high-tech tools for exploring the human brain as it makes financial decisions. And it tells us old things in very new ways that I think give people very powerful metaphors for how to behave better when they invest.
Now you were your own research rat, essentially. So mm-hmm. you got your brain scanned every which way in different situations. Right? So,
right.
So what was one of the most telling experiences that you had that showed up in your brain reactions?
Well, I think one of the central things I learned from being a guinea pig in these experiments that I couldn't have learned in any other way is the difference between expectation and experience. The human brain, it turns out, is designed to expect events much more intensely than we actually experience them. You hope to make money. That's what we call greed. Greed is an intensely powerful experience. But actually making money rarely feels as good as hoping you will make it feels. Likewise, losing money is something we dread when we think about it in the future, even more than we experience when it actually occurs to us. We're all actually more afraid of losing money than we probably should be, because it feels terrible, but it never feels quite as bad as you think it will if you're expecting it.
One of the interesting illustrations where you did not use your brain shows expecting to make money, and it shows the segment of the brain, how mm-hmm. it reacts, and mm-hmm. then expecting dope, which was actually a cocaine user, expecting right. to score or mm-hmm. a hit, whatever mm-hmm. it is. Mm-hmm. What did that show you, number one, and what does it tell you about our brains and our expectations?
Well, what it shows is what I call the prediction addiction. It's very easy for investors, after only a few repetitions of a profitable trade or a stock where the ticks go up, up, up. The stock is $10.12, then it's $10.14, then it's $10.17. You're a genius. You're actually addicted to your own belief in your predictive ability.
And your brain shows an addiction, right?
The way we can identify it is very simple. If you compare a brain scan of someone under those circumstances who's on a hot streak with a financial investment against the brain scan of a drug addict expecting to get the next hit from a needle. You can't tell the two brain scans apart. That's very important for people to realize, because what it tells you is that being right is also dangerous, because that's when people take the wild risks that come home to roost.
When is it that when you're at most danger?
One of the really astonishing discoveries to come out of neuroeconomics is that the brain has automatic formation of expectations. So once something happens twice in a row, you shall believe that it'll happen a third time. So if a stock goes up and then up, it's almost impossible for you not to believe that it's going to go up a third time. And Ben Graham wrote about this many years ago in The Intelligent Investor, when he said the investing public is incorrigible. It cannot count beyond three. And it's as if Ben actually anticipated this discovery of neuroeconomics. And that's important for people to realize, too. You will perceive a trend so fast in the modern internet, you know, financial television world, where things are broadcast continuously in real time. You see ticks constantly. Our parents could only price their portfolios once a day, mm-hmm. maybe once a week. Mm-hmm. We can do it 5 or 10 times a minute. And that leads us to perceive trends constantly. And most of them are just illusions.